Let's talk about 7 no-code tools that you can try in 2024 and beyond. Now, these are some of our favorite no-code tools here at No-Code MBA. And what we're going to do is go through these tools and just briefly talk about what they do and why you might want to try them. So some of these tools are going to help you build web apps. Some are going to help you build websites. We're going to talk about design and marketing as well. So be sure to go through all these tools with us today and then go to the description to learn more about these tools and how you can master them to implement them into whatever it is that you're doing. And if you want to learn more about how to build with no-code tools, and go to nocode.mba, there's a link in the description, to get access to our courses and tutorials. Let's start with Beehiiv. Now, we made a review of Beehiiv recently where we went into all the different types of features and the pricing and the ways that you can monetize using this. And it says here, the newsletter platform built for growth. So it's all about creating your own newsletter. And the way that people do newsletters and monetize them has changed dramatically over recent years. So what we're seeing is more and more monetization tools within the newsletter. So more ways to monetize just within the newsletter. And that's what Beehiiv focuses on. So it allows you to create your own newsletter, your own website, and then monetize within that newsletter. And what we want to focus on is that aspect of it. So these are the three ways in which you can monetize on the platform. Firstly, on your left, you can use the ad network. So Beehiiv has an ad network, which will then put ads into your newsletter, meaning that you don't have to contact different companies and make deals with other companies. The ad network is there. Beehiiv are going to take a cut from this, but it saves you a lot of time and effort because the ad network is built into the platform. The second way is boosts. And this is great because you can generate passive income by recommending other newsletters. So within your newsletter, you can say, check out this other newsletter, and you can create passive income by recommending this, like an affiliate program. And then a very popular way to do this now is premium subscriptions. So you can save your best content or premium content for paid subscribers. So you'll have that free tier, and then you'll have a paid tier so that people will pay in order to get access to this premium content. Again, if you want to learn more about Beehiiv, then check out the review that we made in the description. The next tool is Webflow. Now, you might have heard of Webflow already. I'm going to talk about some alternatives as well. But this is a very powerful platform where you can build websites without writing code with that full CMS, the content management system. So this is perfect for anybody who wants to have full customization over building their website. So if you're building an app, then this tool will allow you to create the marketing website for that app. Additionally, you can create your own blog with Webflow, and you can also link it to other tools such as MemberStack in order to create a membership website within it. And then if you click solutions here, you can see all the different use cases for it. So freelancers, agencies, classrooms, etc., startups too. And then if you want to learn how to build websites with Webflow, then go to nocode.mba and check out our tutorial on how to do this. Now, an alternative to Webflow is Card, C-A-R-R-D. We talk a lot about Card on this platform because it's such a great way to build simple websites. It's a lot less complicated, which means it's not as customizable, but you're able to build simple, free, fully responsive one-page sites for pretty much anything. And the premium plan runs at $19 per year at the time of recording. So if you want to have your own custom domain and all the features, then that is really affordable. Now, Webflow and Card allow you to build websites, but what about web apps? If you're looking for the all-in-one solution, then we recommend Bubble. It says here, the world's only full-stack, no-code platform. So this is going to have a full backend. It's going to have logic that you can use to build web apps. You're going to have the connected database inside Bubble. And you can connect to a host of APIs, such as OpenAI's API. Now, there is a higher learning curve when you're using Bubble compared to other web app or app builders, because it is an all-in-one solution. But because it has a higher learning curve and it's more customizable, it means that you can do so much with this platform. It's a very powerful platform. And if you think that this is going to be something that you want to use, then it's worth learning about this, learning how to use it for the long term. And again, we have a course on Bubble inside our no-code MBA platform. And what I recommend doing after this video too is checking out some of the case studies that we have made that have used Bubble to design their own web apps. For example, AudioPen and FormulaBot are both built on Bubble. And you can also go to use cases here to see what has been built using this platform. The next tool is Calendly. Now, Calendly allows you to schedule meetings online where you can put your calendar up and have people choose the time that they want. So let's say that you're building an app. What you might want to do is reach out to other people to ask their advice. You might want to reach out to influencers to see if they want to promote your app, or to affiliate marketers to see if they want to promote it. You might want to collaborate with other people within the same industry. And as you probably know, if you're sending emails to say, what time are you available next week? Would Tuesday at this time work? And they get back to you a little bit later, it just gets lost. But instead, what you can do with Calendly is create your calendar, specify the time for the meetings, and then block out any times that you're not available. And then in an email, you can say something like, we're looking for influencers to promote our app. We have seen what you've done, and we would love to talk to you more about this. Is there a time next week that can work? Click this link and then choose a time that suits you. So it takes away that friction of back and forth emails, and it's much easier for you and also the person that you're reaching out to. And Calendly has a ton of great features as well, just to make this a lot easier for anyone who wants to create a calendar like this. The next tool is called Typeform. And I really like their headline here. It says, make forms worth filling out, which is great. So a lot of people use Typeform for surveys. They also use it for lead generation too. Here are some of the use cases here. So for marketing, signups and branding, and product, you can do product research, customer success, have some people fill out forms about customer satisfaction. You can build it for your referral business if you decide to create your own affiliate program. So much that you can use it for. But if you're building something like an app, then it is great for customer feedback. And this integrates onto your own website or app, and it just pops up with a form that, again, is really good to use because it's not going to show all the fields at once. Instead, it's just simply, what's your name? Which product did you buy? How many stars would you give it? Etc. So it asks questions in sequence, so it doesn't feel as daunting to the person filling out this form. It's great for lead generation too, especially if you want to segment people. So there might be different areas of your app. For example, there might be a teacher section and a student section, and you want to segment those people into different lead generation journeys. So you can ask a simple question on your Typeform, and then that'll take them through a different segment. So check out Typeform at typeform.com. The next one is Canva, which has become a very popular design tool. And I especially like this because of templates. So no matter what you're designing, for example, it might be a thumbnail, an Instagram post, a Twitter post, it's going to have the template for you. And then you can upload your brand library, for example, your logo, your colors, etc., the fonts that you're going to use. And then it's just simply copying and pasting to create a new post. This is especially helpful for things like thumbnails. And also, Canva has some really new cool features in when it comes to the design part. For example, you can remove photo and video backgrounds in a click. You can get access to 100 million photos, templates, graphics, and videos, and also fix images fast with Magic Eraser. There are lots of different design tools. Most of these are in the Pro account, but Pro is also going to have things like AI features built in to the platform. A lot of people can get away with the free account as well. I know I have done when I've used it for my other businesses, so that's possible too. But as they're adding more features, the Pro version might make more sense for you if you really want to make an all-in-one solution. Now, the next one is not directly a no-code tool, but it's OpenAI's API, which allows you to connect OpenAI and tools that it uses, which allows you to build AI functionality into your app. And additionally, if you are building a no-code app or a website or anything using no-code tools, then OpenAI and the ChatGPT feature is really going to help you with this. It's going to help you with your marketing, with your planning, with your coding, if there's any types of code that you have to implement too. So this is a great tool that I'm sure you're already using, but the API capabilities may be something you haven't thought about. And to learn more about that, check out a video that Seth made where he talks about three app ideas that all integrate AI into them. Now, if you want to learn how to build apps and websites and automations and more using these types of tools, then go to nocode.mba, take a look at our course where you get 60 plus created courses and projects teaching you how to do this. While you're on the website, be sure to check out the reviews to see what other people are saying, founders and other people who have taken the course and built something using no-code tools. And just take a look at to see what they're saying to know if this is going to be for you or not. And we also have lots of free materials on the website too to learn about no-code tools, AI and marketing. And one last thing, are there other no-code tools that we should try? If so, leave them in the comment section below. Be sure to check out that description with all the links that we've talked about in this video. If you're new here, subscribe to the channel and then like this video if you have enjoyed it. Okay, thank you so much for watching and I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.